Welcome all of you to my channel ePhysics for you. Today in this video we shall be discussing a very important topic on quantum spin that may not say very much to you. So let's talk about it. Before we talk about quantum spin, let's take a look at classical spin to better understand it. Classical spin means a particle that revolves around an axis or revolves around its own axis. That is, we mean the angular momentum. We know that the angular momentum has two types. One of them is orbital angular momentum and other is spin angular momentum. The seasonal change is due to the motion of Earth's orbit, which is nothing but a orbital angular momentum. And day night happens due to the Earth rotating around its own axis, which is spin angular momentum. We have an idea in mind that spin means it always revolves around an axis, but this idea is not always true, because about 90 years ago, when physicists were studying the deflection of electrons in a magnetic field, they noticed that the particles acted as if they were spinning under the influence of their magnetic field. But the math shows that this rotation could not be responsible for the field, because it would require the rotation to be faster than the speed of light. That's not allowed. I would like to point out that there is nothing spinning quantum mechanically. So here the analogy is broken down, and we realize that it is confusing to associate an image of an electron with a small rotating object. So, how shall we describe quantum spin? Actually, quantum mechanical spin is an intrinsic property of fundamental particles like charge, mass, etc. It is a pure quantum physical property and has no classical analogy, and it's a mathematical construct to explain the magnetic field seemingly of a stationary electron. Also, the spin is a degrees of freedom of a quantum particle. Here, intrinsic means inherent property of a particle, which will always have it. That means particle with spin just have angular momentum, even if they are sitting totally still. Spin was discovered as a two-state quantum degrees of freedom associated with a magnetic moment. This was done in the Sternegal experiment. Classically, in this experiment, the electrons or magnetic moments were supposed to be deflected in a continuous range, but in this experiment we saw that the electrons were deflected in only two specific directions, suggesting that the magnetic moment had only two observable orientations. This was a very important result in quantum mechanics, because here we found a quantum degrees of freedom other than energy. Spin has served as a prototype for other, even more abstract notions that seem to have mathematical properties of angular momentum. For example, isotropic spin is used in nuclear physics to represent the two states of a nucleon, the proton and the neutron. Similarly, quarks are fair as a isospin, up and down that make up ordinary matter. Spin is quantized. Spin comes in two flavors. One is half integer spin and other is integer spin. Integer spin particles obey the Bose-Einstein distribution rule, and the half integer spin particles obey the Fermi-Dirac distribution rule. Electrons have spin half, so they can have only two spin states. One of them will be spin up or plus half, and other will be spin down or minus half. Physicists have used the term spin or internal spin to distinguish the angular momentum of a particle from the regular angular momentum. Orbital angular momentum is described by SO3 symmetric group, whose simplest or non-trivial representation is 3 cross 3 matrix. On either side, spin is described by SU2 symmetric groups, whose simplest or non-trivial representation is 2 cross 2 Pauli matrix.